were a little quieter, but if you were able to listen to Sunday morning's live stream and the recording of that, I've been told it is much better. And in fact, as you can see, I'm not even wearing a lapel mic. I think we've worked it out for this microphone here to be good enough. So that's the plan today. Hopefully, let us know if something needs to be changed, and we'll take that into consideration. Now, last week I started off by telling you about the closed captions, adding the subtitles to the videos. If you're still having trouble with that, then please talk to me. If you access that by your phone and you bring that with you Sunday morning, I can certainly help you with that. But in general, if you're watching this video on Facebook, if you're watching this on YouTube, there ought to be either like three dots or there ought to be a button with CC on it. You can just tap the CC button, the subtitles will come right on. You tap the three buttons on the video screen itself, and that will give you the option for closed captioning, give you the option for subtitles. So if that was hard to hear last week, then it didn't benefit you at all. But hopefully I just wanted to reiterate that so that, again, if that is something you need, can benefit from, I want you to be aware of it. With that said, we want to jump into the announcements today. It is Wednesday. We are still meeting by phone. And Dave is still teaching. He's teaching in the book of Acts. And tonight will be in Acts chapter 16. Now, you should have gotten an email from Dave yesterday. If you did not, please contact him. Let him know about that. But yes, we're going to be in the book of Acts chapter 16. So be prepared for that. We look forward to that study this evening at 7 o'clock. The other thing we make mention of is about CYC. We still plan on going. They have not canceled it as far as I'm aware. But they are at half capacity, which means we actually need to be able to register as soon as possible. So if you have a teenager, if you have someone you know that is going, please get that money to us. It's $30 for registration. And Hannah and I will be registering here soon for the two of us just to make sure there is a spot going. We're going to have that in by Sunday, but we know some people were home sick, and so rightfully so. And we're hoping that you're doing better. Hopefully, again, all is well there. But please let us know, and we can also have medical sheets for you so that if something were to happen there in Tennessee, we'd have that information on hand. We'd be happy to pass that out to you. The other thing to make mention of is about sending cards to Fairview. I was given a list from Tara, who is the director there, and there's about a list of 14 names. Four people I know for sure have been sent cards, and so that leaves us with 10 other people. Now, you may have sent a card, and I do appreciate it, but all we're asking then is for you to let me know who you've sent a card to so we can keep track of that. Because otherwise, again, as far as my knowledge goes, there's still 10 people that need cards sent. So please, if you haven't sent a card yet, please be thinking about that. If you have, please let me know so we can keep track. I'd appreciate that. Don't forget about the trivia that comes out each week. I do believe the plan is this week, those who are not here, that is being sent to you. We probably will have some copies left over and brought here in person. If there's a week that you missed, don't forget you can check the yellow folder and you can find the previous week's the trivia in there. So be on the lookout for that. Also, again, I know several people have been absent or missing, but as you are here, please check on the back door for the information concerning the directory. And again, I know there are many of you that have already done that, and it is appreciative of that. And as I made mention before about the birthdays and anniversaries, if you could just confirm that. We don't want to have a typo and have the wrong day in there. So please let us know about that, and we'd really appreciate that. The other thing to make mention of is sometimes we get things in the mail. And so this week, we have two things. One is from the Midwestern's Children's Home, which again, we were not able to go this year. But they just sent a letter to us saying thank you. And they I believe they sent this to all of those who supported them this year, and that it has been a difficult year for them. And so you can read about that. I'll put this on the back bulletin board. But we appreciate that, of them acknowledging us and thanking us. The other thing we got in the mail is In Search of the Lord's Way. So again, if you have time, if you're up, when they have their radio program, when they are on the television, please check that out for your local area. Again, that will be in the back as well. Just another opportunity for you to be able to study God's Word, and perhaps you can share that with someone else. And that would be a great opportunity for them as well. Don't forget, we are meeting for Bible study at 9:45. It's something new, something that we haven't done in several months, but please be here at 9:45. Last Sunday, we went over and talking about the defibrillator. If you were not here to be present for that, please talk with Mike. Mike passed out some pieces of paper with the video link on that paper. So if you were not here, not able to watch it, if you perhaps got distracted, then please pick up one of those papers, be able to watch this video on your own time. And we're thankful that Mike went over that with us. With this Sunday coming up, we are going to have back to the adults being out here, and then the classes being broken up into the family groups, and we are trying to manage this as best as we can. But Bible study at 9:45, so please be here for that. And then don't forget, at 10:30 is service. So we look forward to seeing you, if you can, at both of those times. The lesson for Sunday morning is entitled, Are We There Yet? Perhaps that's a question you're familiar with. Perhaps that's a question we know and heard all too often on a road trip. And perhaps that's a question you and I are asking as we're going throughout this year, 2020. Amazingly, it's already November, and it soon will come to an end. But there's a lot that has happened, and so perhaps we're asking that question, are we there yet? What we're going to do is we're going to go and look through several examples in the Bible of people who may have asked that very same question. Are we there yet? Am I there yet? Is this over with yet? And we'll take a look at an example from someone who had to perhaps suffer for just a few hours for a night, for those who had to suffer for years waiting. Won't be able to bring up every example, but hopefully that'll get you thinking, and you can think of other people in Scripture, other people you know who had to suffer and wait for years, acknowledging that we're not alone, that we're not the first group of people that have to be patient, to learn that lesson. So be thinking about that. That'll be Sunday morning's lesson. And we just ask, if you have the opportunity to share these videos online, whether that be through Facebook, whether it be through YouTube, this is the way that we're able to reach out to people. This is the way that people in the community can find out about us and learn more about God's church, find out more about what we're doing here locally in Somerset. So if you have the opportunity, please share the services with people. Please share these videos that may be a benefit to someone else. With those announcements, I want us to turn our focus to prayer. We have been going through and looking at different passages in the Bible, in God's Word, that talk about prayer. We try to take something different, take something away every time, something that's different. And there's a lot to learn as we go from cover to cover, as we go from the beginning to the end of what's said about prayer, who is praying, why are they praying. But today we want to look at Exodus chapter 33. Exodus chapter 33, verse 13. And here it is, Moses praying to God. So Exodus chapter 33, verse 13. It says this, Now therefore I pray, this is Moses speaking to God, I pray, if I have found grace in your sight, show me now your way, that I may know you and that I may find grace in your sight. And consider that this nation is your people. Moses is asking for some direction. Moses is asking for some guidance there. Of God, we've gotten your people out. You've put me in charge, and we have fled Egypt. But I'm looking for some more guidance. Trust me, Lord. may we be able to learn that example from Moses as well. May we be able to go to God in prayer, asking for guidance. May we understand there are some times that we need help, that we don't know everything. Everything's not clear to us. But may we be able to humble ourselves, may we go to God in prayer and be able to ask that He would lead us, that He would guide us. May we remember that, that we have that opportunity through prayer. May we appreciate prayer all the more. So again, I hope these moments, they're very short, but I hope these moments talking about prayer are truly a benefit to you and a reminder to us that we ought to be praying daily. There's not a reason, not a time that we can't or shouldn't be praying to God. We can always think of those wonderful things He's done for us, or we can think of those things that we're having trouble with, and we need God's help. So keep that in mind. With that said, again, just a very short statement about prayer, looking at Exodus chapter 33, verse 13. I want us to look at God's word for a word of encouragement. We've looked at a few different passages. We've really looked for a while at Jesus and His life, and then we looked in the book of Acts and could see some things from early Christians. But I want us today to look at Romans 1. Romans 1, verse 7. Romans 1. Now, Paul is the one writing this letter, and Paul wrote many letters to churches, to brothers and sisters in Christ. But notice this. To all who are in Rome, beloved of God, called to be saints, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, his greetings, his introduction to the churches, to the brethren, would sometimes change, but a very similar introduction that he would give to these people. And what we can see about that is that Paul truly cared about his brethren. And not only cared about the brethren that he saw on a weekly basis, but those other brethren around him. Those that he had interacted with before. Those that he wanted the best for them. He didn't want them to fall back and fall away from God, but yet he wanted them to stay connected. Yet he wanted the church to grow. He wanted them to remain in the faith, to fight the good fight. So maybe take Paul's example. May we write to our brothers and sisters in Christ. May we connect with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Perhaps that's by a phone call, by a text message, by email, whatever it is, but may we take that time out of our day. Again, we can look at the books, the letters that Paul wrote, and we can see just how lengthy some of them are. And that's not what is required of us today, to have several pages worth of information sent to someone. But if we would just say hi, if we would just reach out, let them know that we're praying for them, let them know that if they need help, we are willing to help them. So please, take Paul's example, and what an example that is for us as Christians, to love God first and to love others as ourselves second. How wonderful, wonderful a message that is. Hopefully you're encouraged by that. Hopefully you can encourage someone else by this message. Thank you for watching these announcements. Perhaps you watched it live. Perhaps you're going to watch it recorded later in the day. Again, I hope that you're able to hear this. Stay tuned for any emails, any updates of things that may happen, may change between now and Sunday. But for all of you that cannot be here Sunday, we are praying for you. We hope that you're able